An F1 car's chassis suspension is a masterful feat of design. Its most important components are the suspension mounting and the associated damping systems. Brazil's circuit is especially bumpy, with lots of hard knocks for the suspension. The shock absorbers need to be set up for this in the optimum way possible. That doesn't put any greater demands on the shock absorbers, but the mechanical alignment needs to be different. In general, you allow the spring a bit more travel and thus also need the shock absorbers set up differently, usually a bit softer. A Formula One car gets constantly shaken and put under extreme mechanical strain, areas that a normal car scarcely enters during its entire lifetime.
A track that's bumpy, it doesn't really change anything other than making it very uncomfortable for the driver, because you're just bouncing around and your visibility is jumping about also. And that just doesn't feel right. But it's not really a big problem in driving or something like that.
Nevertheless, over the course of a race, these physical strains add up to such an extent that they can cause the driver to lose concentration. In order to stem this as much as possible, the car needs to be perfectly sprung, an intricate interplay between shock absorber and axle stop. Only an adjustable shock absorber with its push and pull stages can ensure that the wheel is kept ideally pressed to the ground. If you only had a spring, the car would reverberate uncontrollably. It's the shock absorber that hinders unresponsive, unmanageable handling and produces downforce. On top of this comes the alignment of the so-called drop, the setting which, despite hefty ups and downs, gives the wheel the best possible straight-line performance. Combined with the wing setting, you thus get circuit-specific stability into the car and over 700 horsepower in a controlled manner onto the track.
If you've got a pretty bumpy track, you're looking for things not to disturb the car, so you're trying to get the damping to work well, so that when the car goes over a bump, you maintain your grip, and when you go on the accelerator, the car's not disturbed because it goes over a bump. You're basically trying to make sure that the wheels stay in contact with the tarmac for the maximum amount of time.
Hidden under the covers are the systems with which they aim to achieve this. They're quite literally guarded by the teams as highly confidential state secrets. Nobody reveals by what tricks of the trade they always keep firmly on the ground. Well, almost always. Time for a short break. Then it's the news. After that, Water and Grip, how Formula One